looks like this. And we have another show coming up April 18th, Tremoloco and Rick Shea. We're trying to start a new concert venue for Claremont, showcase local talent, and we hope to make it a destination place for everybody in the area. Again, I'm pleased to announce that our venue is starting. Thank you for coming out and supporting us. And so now help me in welcoming, straight back here from Austin, Texas at the South by Southwest Music Festival, GrooveSession.
Story for you guys. It's called the Flying Burrito. We'll be right back. their sticky icky, their cosmic currency. There's no recession or depression or any of that. Then along came a man named Dr. Qtron with a different idea, an idea of conformity, an idea of one radio station, an idea of one music, a monopoly of the industry, and he invented a mini vamping machine. And all the youth think it's the rave, and they're all using it. And this is his jam. This is called The Rise and Fall of Dr. Qtron and the mini vamping machine. Somewhere in a far, far place. We'll be right back. to go on a mission. The elders on the planet have asked that I go and find three of the baddest mamma jammas they got left on this planet to help restore the farm, to end the jamming famine, as we bring the farm back to the city. So please, we ask that you fasten your seatbelts as the Flying Burrito is about to take off. Thank you. You can take your seatbelts off. You're safe. You are now in space. Everybody float around. Uh-oh. Thank you very much. So this brings us to our next tune, which we're going to introduce a groovenaut, a character. His name is Giacomo Jones. He is a very interesting fella, and he's a builder. He's a young groovenaut, but he wasn't affected by the mini vamping machine. He's a bit of a what would be the word?
Outcast.
I wasn't gonna say that. He's not an outcast. He's just more of a indoor guy. I'm an indoor guy. Just depends on the day. But Giacomo apologizes he couldn't be with us today, so he wasn't able to bring all of his tools and his fun stuff. But he's a builder, so he's working in the garage, right, Ronnie? Ronnie actually tells this song, the story, the cartoon, perfect. But Ronnie also doesn't like to talk on the microphone, so that's not gonna happen tonight. But if anyone wants to hear the story, Ronnie will tell you one-on-one, no problem. He doesn't have a problem. Yeah, after. Definitely after.
Thank you.
that's Giacomo's mother, of course. A couple weeks ago, we were down in San Diego, and some good friends of ours who really thoroughly listened to the CD, and they were doing all the clinky clinky stuff on that song. And then we finished the song, and then there was nothing. I'm looking at them, and then I said that, and then they're like, "Oh, okay, now we can clap." Where's Giacomo's mom, man? The song's not over until he goes in for dinner. So, that would give me that. This is called 12 AM, and this is the love song between Giacomo Jones and Nubia, which Nubia couldn't be with us tonight. She got caught in traffic, and she also sends her apologies. Actually, her and Giacomo are together. Yeah. I get way too attached to these characters. But this is called 12 AM, and this is a love song between them. And Nubia happens to be kind of a total opposite of Giacomo. She's really got her stuff going on, very confident woman, and doesn't need a man, but would like one. And Giacomo goes through some transformations. Giacomo goes through some transformations, and ends up finding out that just being himself is the best, and she loves him for who he is. This is their jam, and this is where they go off and do their thing.
Thank you.
for us is an emergency, as serious as war. Sail on, O ship of state. Sail on, O Union strong and free. Humanity with all its fears, with all the hopes of future years, is hanging breathless on my head. What is the answer that I shall give in this name to this great man? Give us the tools, and we will finish the job. We'll be right back. The funk has now been restored. Now we return back to the planet Benson with good news. But they already know the good news on the planet. All the mini vamping machines have been destroyed, falling off of their faces, and the jamming famine is over. At least in the story of the Flying Burrito. We have a lot to do still. And, well, gentlemen, do we want to simmer down a little bit? Sorry for that last one. We weren't actually planning on doing the battle, but telling the story, I mean, what's a good story without the fight scene? Yeah. Although we are warriors of peace, gotta have a little battle every once in a while. Actually, I think we're gonna switch it up right now. We got two new songs for you guys that we really want to do acoustically. Bring it down just a little bit. This is called Promises.
The the gentleness of your whisper, I said, nothing's wrong. Girl, you know I sing it again, I said, nothing's wrong. I done told you, these are my promises.
We got hope, we got love,
keep on talking about change. Let's keep on talking. Ooh. Everybody keep on talking about change. You gotta keep on talking. I said, I keep on talking about change. I wanna keep on talking. Everybody keep on talking about change. And we keep on moving. We've got to keep on moving towards change. We're gonna keep on moving. Everybody keep on moving towards change. And we keep on thinking. We've got to keep on thinking about change. I wanna keep on thinking. Everybody keep on thinking about change. And we keep on loving. I want to keep on loving this change. I wanna keep on loving. Everybody keep on loving this change. Gotta keep on moving. I want to keep on proving this change. I wanna keep on proving. Everybody keep on proving this change.
Kick off your sandals.
What?
Burn them boots.
Let me get mine out.
thank you guys very much. That was the Barefoot Boogie. All we ask is that you walk carefully and don't step on anything. We don't want to be liable. We have had a couple accidents during this song, so we have to throw that out there. Now, something that we had talked about, that this was, because it's such a beautiful and intimate setting, is a little Q&A, which to us, we're like, Q&A? What are you talking about? Like, what kind of questions are they going to ask us? So, I don't know if anyone has any questions or any comments, or it's like, if Ronnie really did make that headband. Ronnie is very talented. He's, besides being an awesome bass player, a really cool brother, he's the man at the beat store. I have to say that he is the man. Actually, he's the only man in there. That's it. He's the only man in there. But he's the man. No, he's amazing. Amazing.
How was Austin?
Tasty.
No, you can't stop talking about the barbecue.
I have a question.
Okay.
Are these songs going to be written coming out of us? Are you going to like songs that you're going to write
about?
Inspired.
Actually, there's a couple songs that have been kind of, they're in us. We just got to, we've been back just for a week and it's been.
That means
no, but really.
We're going to make our next album, the Jumping Pork Rib.
Yeah, we're going to name something about the Jumping Pork Rib or the Tasty Tenderloin. I don't know, something. No, really, there was we met so many great people, beautiful city. For those that haven't been, I would definitely suggest it if you're a music lover. It's just a great city, period. Tons of places to see music, tons of art, just artists in general. It's I don't know if we got any Texans in the house, so I don't want to. Oh, hey, whoa! All right, now you say nothing bad about Texas. No, but it's really different than the rest of Texas. So yeah, definitely check it out. I'd say we're heading back real soon, and we're gonna be doing Austin City Limits. We're gonna be playing between. John Mayer and Grateful Dead. They don't know it yet, but we're going to be doing that. That's going to be a good time. Going to keep our fingers and toes crossed. There's not a song yet, but you may hear something with a Texas tinge to it coming out. And actually, just the new album in general definitely will be coming out really soon. We have a ton of new songs that we're really excited about. We've been playing a lot. Looking forward to getting that to you guys. So, yes, thank you.
Well, one thing with the band, all of us, we're so open-minded to all sorts of music, from reggae to blues to folk to African world rhythms. That's one thing that's great about being a part of this group is that we're so diverse and we all like our own. Like, man, he's big into African stuff.
Hey.
He's only wearing a big dashiki right now. the diversity between us keeps the new material just rolling.
Yeah.
And we all give our two cents every time we go into rehearsal. It's something new. And so that's one of the things that I really enjoy about playing with these guys.
And seeing the transition from the Flying Burrito songs to the songs that we have now, besides now having lyrics and just really forming, we really feel like while we were in the process of writing the Flying Burrito, we were still finding the GrooveSession sound, you know? We found ourselves writing songs that go, man, that sounds like, man, that song kind of has a little tinge of that. And now it's just us, which has been the funnest thing to discover is just hearing it and thinking, man, that's us. You know, that's cool. I'd be lying if I said we haven't worked hard on that. You know, we worked hard on trying to get our own sound. And playing with these two guys, I mean, Ronnie is my brother, but Sarvin is my other brother from a different mother. The three of us, we get along on and off stage, in the van. It don't matter where we're at. We're hanging out, we're cracking jokes. We all have the same sense of humor. which luckily, because I never stop, and it can be annoying if you don't like it, but Sarvin doesn't mind. Or he says, dude.
What kind of jokes?
Nothing appropriate for tonight. I just don't stop, that's all, I just don't stop. I think it's a collection of my family. I have a kooky cat. Kooky family. Yeah, my parents are weird. And I thank them for that. I thank them for that every day. Yes.
Actually, I don't know if most people know this, but I started playing piano originally when I was four. My dad plays piano and guitar, and my parents bought me a guitar when I was 10, and I didn't touch it. I actually was just like, I'm staying in the piano, I'm a piano player. And then one day I just started picking it up, learning some chords, learning some Beatles tunes, and then from there I started listening to everybody from the likes of Jimi Hendrix to the Allman Brothers to the great classic rock artist Led Zeppelin. And then I got into reggae, Latin music. Stevie Ray Vaughan obviously is a big influence. And now I just kind of keep myself open to everything from crazy, crazy fusion jazz to bluegrass, anything. It's really a great learning experience, and these guys definitely keep me on my toes and make me up my game a little bit.
Ronnie, who inspired you?
Oh. I thought he was talking about her dad or something. I don't know what he was thinking.
I thought I was going to get by.
Jack Bruce.
Yeah. Jack Bruce. Definitely with the raw sound. That's one of my big ones. A lot of the 70s fusion genres of Stanley Clark, we got Marcus Miller, we have Return to Forever, all the 70s fusion. I love the funk, a lot of different funk.
Gotta have that.
So, definitely a pluck on the string I like. And there's a lot of artists today. I mean, Soul Live, we got Fish, yeah, what else is there?
And if you notice, Ronnie's naming bands, and that's the one thing with musicians. Don't only be influenced by, if you're a guitar player, just by guitarists. Be influenced by bass players. Be influenced by drummers or bands as a unit.
Horns.
Horn players.
Yeah.
And a lot of guitarists listen to a lot of saxophone
drummers.
Players.
Drummers as well.
Well, you make a bass talk, and that's unusual. That's not the norm. It's usually the sound out.
He invented the language of the Groovenauts. He invented it. One night we heard some going on, like, man, is that Giacomo? Who is that? And I was like, it was just Ronnie. We liked it. So this last one, I think the last song. We got two more songs? Would you like to hear two more songs?
Yeah.
All right. Let's do it. Thank you guys very much. This right here is a cover song. We weren't really planning on doing any cover songs tonight. I don't know why. We love doing the ones that we do. Kind of pays homage to them and our way of thanking them for doing what they do and did. Inspires us in our lives. But this tune, we started doing in We started doing this one when we first started playing together, or shortly after we had been playing together, and it really turned into something special for us. We tried to make it our own. This is called She's So Heavy by the Beatles. I want you.
Two, three.
Thank you. sing this part right here. And it's real simple. All I'm gonna do is spell out GrooveSession. Now you gotta remember it's double O, double S. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So I sing G-R-O-O-V-E-S-E-S-S-I-N. GrooveSession is your friend. G-R-O-O-V-E-S-E-S-S-I-N. GrooveSession is your friend. G-R-O-O-V-E-S-E-S-S-I-N. GrooveSession is your friend. We just want to be your friend. G-R-O-O-V-E-S-E-S-S-I-N. GrooveSession is your friend. G-R-O-O-V-E-S-E-S-S-I-N.
GrooveSession.
Yeah.
Actually, we got one more brand new song that we really like to do for you guys. I don't know if we got enough time. It's a shorty. Is it short? Okay, we're going to give you guys a shorty. This is a real shorty. It's about a 30 minute. Actually, that's how long the Flying Burrito is. That's how long that song is. That's why we don't play that one all that often. Oh, man. But this is called I Want to Give Me Some of That, or Just Give Me Some. And this is a brand new song. And we got to do it up for you guys right now.
Thank you.
our Groove Session. And we thank each and every one of you guys very much. Cannot thank you guys enough for everything that you've done for us. And always sending a beautiful energy. Ken, Code Blue, Claremont, everybody, thank you guys very much. The Garden of Eden, can't thank you enough. Mom and Dad, everybody, thank you guys.
I came into a place I'd never seen before. Holding fear at bay wasn't much of a chore. See, light was soft, and joy was loud. Hope was even shared in this quiet crowd. Was I in heaven, or deep in far lands? All I know is beauty flourished like ear-tickling fans. It was the smell of love now, rich in the air. Everyone was given, and everything fair.